Download links to the files created in this video are in the description. This is the second in a series of videos on how to create a Celtic Triskelion. In the first video, I created a Triskelion using the Inkscape Create Spirals tool. In this video, I'll make the spirals using the Inkscape Create Circles and Ellipses tool. You can choose whichever method you prefer between the method in this video and the method in the previous video. I prefer this method because it gives more control over the shape of the spirals. With that said, let's get started. Let's set up our document. Go to File, Document Properties. Set the display units to pixels. Uncheck Show Page Border. Close Document Properties. Let's come over to Create Circles, Ellipses, and Arcs with the letter E keyboard shortcut. Click and drag to create a circle. Then come over to the Circle Properties. Set the RX value to 10 and the RY value to 10. The circle might become very small. Just hover over the circle handles, press Ctrl, and press and hold Ctrl and scroll up to zoom into the circle. Next, let's switch to the Select and Transform tool. Now make sure we've got proportional scaling locked, and that we've also got the proportional scaling for stroke width disabled. So this setting right here. When scaling objects, scale the stroke width by the same proportion. This setting should be disabled. Next, let's go to Object, Fill and Stroke. Come to the Fill, set it to None. The stroke paint, set it to flat color, and the stroke style, make sure the units are in pixels, and set the stroke width to 10 pixels. You'll get a circle that looks something like this. Let's come down to the opacity and bring it down to about 50%. After you've set the stroke width on the dimensions of the circle, you should get a width and height of 30 pixels. If not, then set them to 30 pixels. Next, let's come back to the circle. On your keyboard, press Ctrl D, On your keyboard, press the key combination Ctrl and D to duplicate the circle. Once you've duplicated the circle, come to the width and height properties of the duplicate and set the width to 50. Press Ctrl D to duplicate again and set it to 70. Ctrl D to duplicate again and set the width and height to 90. And Ctrl D one more time and set the width and height to 110. Oops, sorry. 110. And zoom back into the objects. Next, click and drag over everything to select everything. Then come to Object, Align and Distribute. Set the relative to biggest object and align on the center vertical axis. Center on the vertical axis and center on the horizontal axis. and you'll get your circles looking something like this. Next, click on the side to deselect everything. Then click on the smallest circle. I'm going to press Ctrl and scroll up to zoom in. After selecting the smaller circle, let's come to the Create Circles and Ellipses tool. On the circle properties, go to the end value and enter the value 180. That will change the circle into an arc. Come to the second circle, change the start value instead of the end value to 180. If the circle is closed, then set it to arc, unclosed shape. On the next circle, set the end value to 180. Switch to arc or unclosed shape and alternate between the circle's end value and start value. So on this circle, we're using the start value, and switch to arc, unclosed shape. Then I'm going to control and zoom out, control and scroll down to zoom out. And on the last circle, I'm going to set the start value to 120, and the end value to 180, and switch to arc. Next, let's come over to enable snapping. Make sure you've got snap nodes, paths, and handles. Snap cusp nodes, and including rectangle corners. Snap smooth nodes, including quadrant points of ellipses. All of those enabled. Make sure you've got all of those enabled. Let's switch to the Select and Transform Objects tool. Then come click and drag on the second arc and drag it to the left to snap it onto the smallest arc. Sometimes the shapes may distort, that's just a bug in Inkscape. You can zoom in and zoom out to restore the proper view. Next, let's come to this arc and snap it onto the rest, and you'll get a spiral. Click and drag over all of the arcs to select them. Then go to Object, Group, or keyboard shortcut Control G. Once you've grouped them together, press Control D or right click on the object and click Duplicate. Click and drag the duplicate to the side, then click the duplicate again to reveal the rotation handles, and click and drag the rotation handle and press Ctrl to snap it at 120 degrees. The angle will show at the bottom of your screen. Once it's snapped at 120 degrees, click and drag it to snap it onto the other spiral. Press Ctrl D to duplicate it again. Click it again to reveal the rotation handles. Click and drag. And press Ctrl to snap it at 120 degrees. Then click and drag to snap it onto the rest of the arcs, or the rest of the spirals. And now you've got three spirals that form a triskelion. Click and drag over all of them, and then press Ctrl Shift G to ungroup everything. Once everything is ungrouped, you can see that all of the individual objects have their bounding boxes. Come over to path, stroke to path. After doing that, come back to path again and union. And that combines all of the spirals into one object, and we now have our Triskelion. Let's switch back to fill and stroke, so you can come to the fill and stroke menu, click the up arrow to reveal it, and let's bring the opacity back up to 100%. I'd prefer to leave my Triskelion like this, but if you want to rotate it, then you can do that too. Let's click on the Triskelion again to reveal the rotation handles, then click and drag to rotate it. If you don't like the direction it's facing, you can also flip it or mirror it. And lastly, if you don't like the triangle in the center there, we can go to the Edit by Nodes, zoom in, and click and drag over all three of these nodes, and press Delete to remove them. Switch back to the Select and Transform tool, zoom out, and there's your Triskelion. So that's how you create a Triskelion using the Inkscape Create Circles and Ellipses tool. You'll notice in the center it looks more symmetrical than using the Inkscape Create Spirals tool. And yeah, you can use whichever method you prefer. The Create Spiral tool is much faster than this method, but this one I think brings out a nicer result. So thanks for watching. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below, and I'll see you in the next video.